said and done. So if you've been sifted and you've survived, you have a greater anointing to advance the kingdom of God. You're not then hunkering down when the day of evil comes. You are in advancement mode. You are in battle mode. You know, we are the hands and feet of God on the planet. We are His hands and feet. He uses us to do His work. He's ordained it that He uses His body to advance the kingdom of God. You know, I want to end with talking about character. And we talked a little bit about it, but I feel like I need to share this. Because when we go through a trial, it builds our character. It should build our character. If we go through a trial and our character, we have a choice. We can either murmur and complain and whine and carry on, or we can get with God's plan and say, God, I'm going to praise you anyway. I'm going to have faith anyway. It doesn't matter what happens. I am going to have faith in the Most High God. It doesn't matter what's coming after me. When our character comes into agreement with the character of Christ, we are more likely to get to the end of that stage of perseverance. Sometimes people never get their character built. That's why they never get out of that time of having to have perseverance. And, you know, there are a lot of people in Scripture who had to have their character built. We talked about Abraham. Another one is Joseph in the Old Testament. Joseph was sold into slavery by his brothers. He was put into prison. He was in slavery and in prison for 13 years. And in one day, he went from the prison to being the prime minister of Egypt in one fell swoop. He stopped on the wayside to get a bath. That's all it took for him to get from the prison to the prime minister position. And the reason, I thought, Lord, why did Joseph have to stay in prison 13 years? You know what? His character was so formed in God the time he got out of prison that when his brothers came before him, he had God's purpose in his mind. He had the vision of God's purpose. You know what? He had the power. He could have annihilated his brothers right there. Nobody would have ever known the difference. He had already set them up. He had already had them falsely accused of a crime. He could have had them executed, and they would have been gone. They would have been done for. But you know what he would have executed in the process? He would have executed the ancestral line of Jesus Christ. Jesus came through the line of Judah, one of his brothers. Didn't come through Joseph, came through Judah. So if he had executed Judah and all the rest of his brothers, he would have executed the carrier of the seed of the earthly seed of Jesus, and he would have thwarted God's plans. His character had to be so well formed, and it was formed by being in the fire, that when his brothers came before him, he said in Genesis 50:20, you meant for harm, but God meant it for good. What you intended to harm me, God intended for good. It was only because he had godly character that he could see that the hardship that he had been through for 13 years was for a godly purpose. You know, we get a vision or a word or an understanding of who we are in Christ. It's like a diamond in the rough. You know, God speaks to us as diamonds in the rough. But the diamond has to be cut to fulfill its purpose. A diamond in the rough looks like a rock. You know, it just looks like an interesting rock. It's only when the bad places are cut away that it really starts to reflect the light. You know, that's what a diamond is. It reflects the light. There's no light in a diamond. It just reflects the light. And that's who we are in Christ Jesus. When we're just in our unpurified form, we're just a rock. But as those places that are impure are cut off, it begins to reflect the light. And when we begin to reflect the light of Christ. And so the vision that God has for us, it illustrates who God can see us being. When we have a prophetic word or an understanding from God, it's God's idea that I have a plan for you and this is what my plan for you is going to look like. A prophetic word or a vision or an understanding, it is a tool of acceleration to get you from where you are to where God wants you to be. You know what? If Joseph hadn't exercised godly character, he might have been in prison 25 years. He might have been in prison 30 years. You know, God said when the drought came that created the famine in his homeland. You know, God did that. What if his character had not yet been formed where he could be useful to God? What if our character never gets formed? Are we useful to the Lord? We have to yield and submit our character to be Christ-like so that even in the day of hardship, and we say, God, just, you know, this is what I've been praying for the last several months in my life is, God, you know, I've said build my character quickly, but honestly, it's up to me to build my character. It's up to you to build your character. I say, God, help me build my character quickly because I don't want to have to persevere on and on and on and on. I want my character built. I want my character to be godly character that God can use me the way he wants to use me. So that's my prayer for today. If our character is not where God needs it, it can make things a lot worse. You know, that the vision that the Lord has for us is that we're going to be useful to him. We're going to be useful in his kingdom. We're going to do the things that he's called us to do. And he will build us. He will mold us. He will put us in the fire. And, this morning we were listening to Adrian Rogers on the radio station. And he was talking about God wants you holy more than he wants you healthy. And anyway, it was this whole thing about healing and whatever. But he was saying, God will put you in a place that will help you get holy. And then when you come out the other side, then he will promote you. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were the three young Hebrew men that ended up in the fiery furnace. And you know what? They had perseverance. They stood through the test of time. They went to the fiery furnace knowing it was seven times harder. They had vision. They knew who God was. They said, our God can save us, but if he doesn't, we're still going to stand with our God. They had faith. But you know what? They went, that walk to the fiery furnace was a walk to their promotion. If they had kneeled down and worshiped that idol before they got there, they would have never been promoted. It was only after they went into the fire and they came out the other side that they were promoted, they were elevated in the kingdom of Nebuchadnezzar. You know, sometimes we have to go through that fire to get to the place where we're purified enough to be promoted in God's kingdom. So I just want to pass it back to Brother Rob. I don't know what you want to do for
me. Well, Randy's going to play, and we're going to invite you to come for prayer if you'd like this morning. Laura and Mike will be here.